Hello everyone! In this video we're gonna learn how to differentiate functions like this, which is basically powers of x. Now, this derivative rule is very common in the IB math, AA or AI, standard and high level. So here, to differentiate x power of n, first, we drop the power of n down and multiply it by x. As we see here, the power of n is down, and it's multiplied by x. Then also, we decrease this power here, n, by 1, so it becomes n minus 1. So here, first we put the n down and multiply it by x, and then we subtract 1 from n, so we have n minus 1. Let's now have some examples. Here we have f of x equals x power of 5. So here, first, we denote the derivative like this, f prime. So this denotes the first derivative of function f. F prime x equals here. So as we said, first, we put the power of 5 down and multiply it by x. Then, we decrease the power by 1, so we will have 5 minus 1. And if we simplify this, f prime is equal to 5 multiplied by x power of 4. Here we have 5 minus 1. So the derivative of x power of 5 is 5 multiplied by x power of 4. Another example here. We have 5 multiplied by x cubed. Here, if the function is written like this using y, so the derivative is denoted like this, y prime. Again here, we put the power of 3 down and multiply it by the function. So here, we will have 3. Then we multiply by 5 as it is, then we decrease this power by 1 and it becomes 2. If we simplify this, so y prime is equal to, here we have 3 times 5 which is 15, then multiplied by x squared. So this is the derivative of this function. Now, another example here. Here we have 8x. Now, of course, as we know, if we don't have a power on x, then it would be 1. So now we can differentiate normally here, f prime x equals. First, we put the power of 1 down and multiply it by 8, which will be 1 times 8, which is 8. Then we will subtract 1 from the power here, so we will have 1 minus 1, which is, of course, 0. So here we have 0. And as we know, x power of 0 is 1. And then 8 times 1 will be just 8. Now, of course, from now on, we don't need to do the question or the function here like this. We can do it faster. So basically, if we have 8x, then the derivative will be just 8, the coefficient. If we have like 7x, then the derivative will be 7. Negative 2x, then the derivative will be negative 2. So here, for example, if f of x is equal to negative 4x, then the derivative will be just the coefficient, which is negative 4. Another example here. Here we have f of x equals 3. Now, as we see here, we don't have any x. Or we can just imagine that we have x but raised to power of 0. Because x power of 0 is 1 again, and 3 times 1 is 3. So here, when we differentiate this, then we put the 0 down and multiply it by 3. So 0 multiplied by 3. And as we know, when we put the 0 down and multiply it by these, then everything will be 0, because 0 multiplied by anything will be 0. So the derivative of this function becomes 0. Now here, a fast rule then from now on. If you have just a constant function like this of any number, then the derivative will be immediately 0, if we don't have x here. So if f of x is equal to just a constant number and no x, then the derivative will be 0. Here, for example, if f of x is equal to negative 7 plus Let's say, for example, 3 over 2. You notice that it's only a constant function and it doesn't have any x. So the derivative will be immediately 0 for any constant. Here now we have some more functions. Here we have 6 divided by x squared. Now, before we differentiate this, I wrote here that to differentiate, the function should be written in the power form. So here, it's more convenient here to write the function like this first, in the power form. F of x equals 6 times. Here, if we put the x squared above here, and in that case, we will change the power and it becomes negative 2. As we know, if we raise x squared above to the numerator, we reverse the sign of the power, so it becomes negative 2. And now we can differentiate it as we learned. So the derivative will be, first, we multiply negative 2 by 6, then we will have negative 12, and we will subtract 1 from this power, so it will become negative 3. And if we need to put it down again, the x power of negative 3, we can make the power positive. So the derivative is negative 12 divided by x cubed. Here we have another example. And as we said, first we would write it in the power form. Any square root means power of half. So here we have x, power of half. Now, to differentiate this, first we put the power of half down and multiply it by negative 10, and that would be negative 5. Then here we will decrease 1 from this power. Half minus 1 would be negative half. So here we have negative half. Now, to simplify this, we can write negative 5 divided by x power of positive half. And as we know, x power of half down can be written like square root of x. Now, here we have a function that has many different terms. And of course, differentiation is distributable over these terms. So we can differentiate each one of them one by one. First, we will rewrite the function so that all of them are written in the power form. 5 multiplied by x power of 4 as it is, minus 9x. Here, we will put the x up and it will be x power of negative 1. Then, plus 2 as it is. Now, we will differentiate each term separately. So, f prime equals, here we put the 4 times 5 would be 20. And we decrease the power by 1, so x cubed, minus, as we said, when we have just like 9x, then the derivative will be 9. So here, minus 9, plus, here, we put the negative 1 down and multiply it by 3, so it becomes negative 3. And we decrease the power, so it will be negative 2. And here we have a constant, and as we said, the derivative of any constant is immediately 0, so we don't need to write it. Now, we will simplify the function. So f prime is equal to 20x cubed minus 9 minus 3. If we put the x down, it will be power of positive 2.